Hi everybody, Pierre from Reception Academy. Today we are going to discuss the correction of the exercise number 12 from our home study guide.
Please note this tutorial video has been designed for students taking the Opera PMS home study course. If you don't have already access to the software, you could find more information about the course on our website. I have added the course link to the video description below, and you could get Opera PMS installed and tag along. You just have to click on Book Now.
For this exercise, I have created a booking under the name of John Doe. Let me open it for you. It is a reservation arriving today, as you can see it's due in, for two nights for the guest. For the first task, your guest wanted a portable item. Item inventory drop-down menu, click on it. Click New. Select your portable item from your list. Click on OK. You don't need to change the date, as it is for the days of stay. The quantity is 1, click on OK. You can see that your request has been created. Click on OK to close that window. And then you want to press Save. The system will prompt you with a trace text if you want to create it. Say yes. And here you can see the detail of the trace. You just need to confirm the details. Once you're happy, you press OK. And save. Your guests never want to be disturbed. So what you wanted to do is different things. You wanted to create a profile note to remember it for future occasions, as he never wants to be disturbed. And you also wanted to create a reminder, which is an alert, to ensure that whenever there is a visitor or phone call received, we don't divert the call. I also like to add it into traces to give departments who should be aware about it a head start. That involves housekeeping because they clean the bedroom, room service because they bring food, home service, because there is a minibar, that will be also for the concierge, because they deliver messages, and of course, reception and switchboard. They got the alert, but it's also good for them to have, in the morning brief, this trace. Finally, we will add a little 3 letters to the comments. I will show you that in a moment. So let's start with the profile notes. I go to my profile ellipsis, just like so. I go to my options, and I click notes. I select from my list general notes because it is more than one department. And here in title, I will put DND for do not disturb, and I will type in my message. Guests never want to be disturbed. If you haven't copied it yet, highlight it, Control plus C to copy it. You will paste it into your trace. Then press OK. Close your individual notes window. Press OK on your profile to close it. You wanted to create your alerts. To do so, click on Options, click on Alerts, select from your list DND for Do Not Disturb Guest, press OK, and you want this message to pop up throughout the stay. So from your area, you will have to pick Reservation. Press OK, and close. Now in addition to that, I'd like to do Traces, as I mentioned previously. Click on Traces, select New. And here, you will select the department mentioned. So it was reception, concierge, switchboard, housekeeping, and a little bit down your list, you should have room service. And here, because we copied the message, we can paste it by doing Ctrl and V. Guests never want to be disturbed. Press OK to create your traces. Close your traces window. And close your reservation options window. Finally, in comments, you wanted to put a star, like you finish a sentence to start a new one, like a period, and then DND, do not disturb, that to give an extra indication for the reception team when they will open the booking. Press save. Your guests will be in the bar from 6 p.m. till 8 p.m. As you know the location and the timing, it's a locator. Click on options. Select locator. Don't need to change the date, you just need to put the timing. So that was 6 p.m. You need to write it down as 1800 and 8 p.m. which is 2000. And then press tab. Now a good practice is to click on the ellipsis just here to find the most common location. And you can see that there is guesses in the bar. At the cross, press OK. Then you just need to click OK to validate your locator. and press close. Close your options window and save. Add the second guest name to the booking. Click on options, select accompanying, and type in the second guest last name, Do, and the first name, Jessica. Click search, and if you don't have any result, click on new. If you have the result, check the telephone number and the email address. Then you want to add the title, and you want to add an email address and a telephone number. Once you are happy with all the details, you just need to press on OK. And then you press close on the accompanying window and close on your options and save. The next task was to attach the guest company profile, go to company and type in the company name. Reception Academy. Press tab. Here I've got some results. If I didn't have any result, I click search and then I can click new. I will open the one which is 10 White Row by double clicking on it. And here you can see the details you will have typed in, the address with the correct casing and the generic information of the business, telephone number and email address. Once you're happy with those details, you want to click on OK. Your company profile is now attached. Your market is set on leisure. This needs to be updated to corporate just here. Then click save. Prior to check-in, as our guest is arriving today, and we've got a room specific due to the portable heater, and the room will be specific as we are organizing the portable heater, I will assign a room in advance, which is 401. That's okay. And I will put a star, the letter DNM, do not move, do not change room number if you prefer, and the reason why, which is POHI. Now POHI is a code of portable heater which is just here. And then I press save. I will now check in my guest and I will go up to cashiering billing. I will accelerate the process, so I will catch you again once we reach the billing window. We are now on the bill of the guest and we need to do the posting. So I click on post. And the first item we had to post was minibar. You say yes to post an article, and I select white wine. That's okay. Press enter to go to the next line. Then my guest had a dinner in the restaurant, so restaurant, dinner food. That was £100. Press enter to go to the next line, and he had some drinks for £20. So restaurant again, dinner, and this time we select beverage, and £20. Then he had internet in his room, so that was internet. Select internet in room, that was for £15. Followed by the independent newspaper, so here what you do, you type newspaper. Press tab, the system says, do you want to post article? You say yes, and you select the independent newspaper, which is here, that's okay. Enter. Then my guest broke a kettle. Now, a broken kettle is an item which belongs to the hotel, so that would be miscellaneous. That was £60. And in reference, you put broken kettle. Then my guest went to the theater. We are flexible to choose which show he went for. Because it is a theater ticket, we need to purchase it in advance on the bill for the guest and we charge his bill. This is a paid out. So paid out, let's say £80, yeah, right on, theater ticket, and in my supplement, I will write down Lion King. So I press enter to go to the next line. Copies, you could print one, it's good for your record, however, here is just the exercise, so I press close. That was it for the posting, so I press close here. And all the charges I have posted are back on my bill. Guest paid £10 by cash. To record it, you want to go to payment. You will select the cash icon and change your amount to £10. Then click post. And here you will see your £10 by cash has been recorded on the system. For the next task, you have to rename the window to under the company name. And also your guest company will reimburse him for the dinner and internet. So once you rename the bill, we will have to move the items to that window. First, open the second window, perform a right click and select new window. Then you click on options and you select the routing. At top of the form, click on window. Then you want to click on the name drop-down menu. Select your company name. And here is for window 2. We are fine. You just need to press OK. Close. Say no to refresh folio. And close your options. So window 2 has been renamed under the company name. Then what you wanted to do, it was to move your internet and your dinner. So don't forget to select both charges at once. And drag and drop. Guest complains about minibar, he never used it. So he wanted to select your minibar, perform a right click, select adjust transaction. Then you wanted to select the top one, adjust by selected postings, press OK. In reason code, that will be other reason. Percentage 100% and reason text. Guest never use minibar, charge removed. Then you click on OK. The system will prompt you that the charge has been adjusted. Press OK. And here you will see that in addition to your plus minibar, you have now the discount of 5.50 which has been applied. Because there is nothing left to pay out of that minibar, we need to select both items and move it to an empty window. Select both items, perform a right click, select transfer to window. An empty one is window 3. And here you will see that both charges has been moved to your window 3. The total balance of that window is 0 pound. In addition to that, your guest had a special offer on the dinner and we did it to discount 25% of the dinner. So select on your window 2, both items from the dinner, perform your right click, select adjust transaction, by selected posting, press OK, reason code, promotional discount, percentage 25%, and then in reason text, you wanted to write down your reason, 25% discount on dinner, special offer. Then you click on OK. The system prompts you that this time two charges has been adjusted, click OK. And here you will see on your window 2, your positive charges and your two discounts which are in minus. Those charges do not need to be moved somewhere else because the guests still have 75% left to pay. So you need to leave all of them on the window 2. This brings the correction of our exercise number 12 to an end. Thank you for watching and see you in our next video.